Now remember, if you're going to communicate over long distances through wire, what you need to do is you need to have a code, because you can't talk. You need to have a tapping sound. So this is where the Morse code comes in handy. Now this again is a method for transmitting telegraphic information using standardized sequences of these long and short beeps. Long and short elements can be formed by dots and dashes. For instance, dit, 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 and then if you go to O, da, 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 and then an S again, dit, 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 is the same thing that the Titanic tried to tell the Californian that was 20 miles away to get people to help them because the ship was sinking, and that is the Titanic. Not that you would remember the Titanic, but you would remember the movie. So, if you can communicate and you can develop something that can go over a long distance of time, you can bring yourself back to the Old West days. And in the Old West days, they set up wire telegraphs. And you'd often see pictures of natives chopping down these telegraph poles because they figured something was being transmitted through these wires, and they were right. It did definitely communicate messages that helped with Western expansionism that totally helped annihilate all the Indian nations. In fact, this is how Western Union got started.